So hey guys, welcome back to the channel, and without wasting any more second on this intro, let's get started. So as you saw in the title, that explains 12 is announced. It was announced about 10 hours ago, my local time. I'm recording this video on 26th of September, 2 PM almost, and this was announced last night, 12-13 hours ago. So yeah, let's get started. So first of all, Laminar announced X-Plane 12 at Flight Sim Expo, which is in San Diego. As you can see right here, we have been busy doing a live from Flight Sim Expo. So this is the official announced video of X-Plane 12, not 11, 12. So, first of all, let's see what features will be coming in the X-Plane 12. I was gonna say. So, first of all, weather. If you know Austin, I'll show you this. Austin. Yeah. I wrote this for you. I'm sorry. Yeah, so this man is one of the head developers of X-Plane Laminar Research. So this is Austin Effendi. So Austin talked about the weather. So in X-Plane 11, the weather worked on meta report, which is an, if someone's wondering what's meta, so meta is a report available to the pilots at the airport. It's updated every 1 hour. Yeah. It's similar to ATIS, but it doesn't tell you that active rays and all. It just tells you the weather report. So earlier I explained worked on META, but now it will work on global grid that surrounds the Earth and simulates the weather from an algorithm. So there will be a grid which will surround the Earth and weather will be simulated from an algorithm. This forecast is computer generated. So they'll use forecast, computer generated, and which will cover the whole world. It will also go forward in time. That means the weather, you know, will get updated from time to time, and there will be a smooth transition. In X-Plane 11, I set the refresh rate to 15 minutes. So after 15 minutes, all the weather, all of the cloud will be, you know, away, Gaia, and then it will come back after weather is done. So it will not happen in X-Plane 12. It will be a smooth transition. This allows global weather that covers space and time. So, and yeah, it will also use META. So this both will blend in and will allow weather that can work smoothly. Okay, so next, clouds. This is Ben, one of the top engineers of X-Plane. So earlier X-Plane used not volumetric, 3D clouds, but 3D clouds then were not very realistic, as you know. It was just like you are flying into a blackish grayish room. You know, it was just like that. But now, in X-Plane 12, volumetric clouds will be used, which is a ton more realistic than, you know, the other clouds, 3D clouds. Right? So, next. Librium. So, earlier we used Librium for realistic rain on your windshield, but now, Librium will be integrated with X-Plane and rain emulation will be very realistic. I'll put the link to this in the description. You can see it. They have also shown the rain effect, and trust me guys, it was very nice. Yeah, see, I'll just play it. Okay, so I'll just mute and...
raindrops on your graphics card. Now,
see, it's looking so realistic, guys. This groundwater is also added. And now, Explain 12 will be used, will be generated on using real physics. Like, earlier the Explain didn't have like this water effect. As you know, it just looked like, you know, the developer himself said that in Psychomistics 4 interview, FSLike interview, sorry. He told that, and it looked like there's a plastic sheet on the rim. But now, if this will be implemented, you know, wet and puddles and waste contamination, hydroplaning, this all will be introduced in Explain 12 as they are now working on real physics. So, for example, if the sun is 6 giganets, the unit is something like that only, I don't remember. So, just say 6 giganets. This is just an example, guys, it's not real. Students, please don't use this as your exam tutorial. I'm just saying something. Just to make you guys understand. So if the sun is 6 giganets, then in Explain they have used 6 giganets only. So 1-to-1 replica, scaled replica of real engine physics. Right. So yeah. And see the rain now will this, to be honest, this doesn't look very realistic to me. But yeah, see, so it will look like this, quite nice, right? See, I'm going to full screen, yeah. See, it will look like this, and this video is a nice topic to coming on to my next new thing, which is the A330, yes. So till now, in the history of laminar research, they only, you know, themselves, they developed only Boeings and McDonnell Douglas and all. But for the first time, the laminar team itself designed the A330. And this fly-by-wire system that Austin, the man I showed you here, he himself developed this fly-by-wire model, which is, and it includes alpha flow protection and a ton more things. So we're excited to see that. In summary, the AC30 has realistic fly-by-wire simulation, realistic 3D modeling, ECAM missiles, failure and fully modeled landing gear, you know, the tilted landing. Right, and one more thing, realistic fly-by-wire simulation, and yeah, this AC-30 has been tested by real-life pilots, so they said that this is the closest you can go and this is the best you can go, you know, simulator, so then this is, you know, will come. Then they have also added new sound engines, so the sound engine will include winds, leaf, you know, rustling of leaves and high and low winds, thunder, rain, cars, even birds. So you can actually hear the cars and birds go if you are very close to the ground. They also react accordingly to the time of the day, weather and mood. So the car, these all things will react on the time of the day, weather and mood. Know those things. And next, very important, Explain 12 we will have animated jetway connection, so you will not need to spend even a penny on SAM for World of Jetways. It will be animated, right? You can see it right here, the world. So now they'll use 3D forest engine. Trees will be 3D if they are nearby, but those are a way they are rendered accordingly to the airport scenery, seasons, you know. So a lot will change in X-Plane 12. The new fleet, Cirrus SR-22 is coming in the new fleet, Citation X, AT-30, F-14 Tomcat, and this is also developed by the Lamna team itself, R-22 and RV-10, never heard of these. Let me check. R-22, right? Aircraft. That was R-22, right? Yeah. R-22 aircraft. Okay. Helicopter. It's helicopter. And RV-10. Let's check what this RV-10 aircraft. Okay. Nice. So ATC is also improved. Now the ATC will not vector you into the mountain. And VFR is also added. Regional accents and voices will be included. New ATC system will be more accessible to Hotas and VR users. Upgrading. And Thompson confirms that the early access of X-Plane come out soon. It will. If you buy a key, then you will get access to both X-Plane 11 stable version and X-Plane 12 early access version. So, and yeah, this thing is over. So, they added many things, AT-30, new sound engines, and you know, ton of more things. Push to talk, they also added push to talk. Guys, you can just see this video, I'll put the link in description. And so yeah, I'm very excited for X-Plane 12, how it will look. And so, yeah guys, thank you for watching today's video, and if you wanna be updated on the latest aviation and flights and news, subscribe to the channel and hit that like button. That will be greatly appreciated. Subscribing is free, if someone's wondering. So yeah, there's no reason that you're not you should not subscribe. You should subscribe right away. So yeah guys, thank you for watching today's video, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Till then, take care.